fa, 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 fa,
fa,
fa,
fa,
fa,
fa,
fa,
fa.
I command them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Say, God Almighty, you are holy.
God Almighty, you are holy.
You are wonderful.
You are wonderful.
You are glorious.
You are glorious.
I love you so much.
I love you so much.
You are God of Abraham.
You are God of Abraham.
God of Isaac.
God of Isaac.
God of Jacob.
God of Jacob.
I worship you.
I worship you.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord.
You are my Lord.
You are my Savior.
You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me my sins.
Bless me today.
Bless me today.
Protect me from today.
Protect me from today.
With your power,
with your power
of the Holy Spirit.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are the Alpha.
The Omega.
The Omega.
The King of Kings.
The King of Kings.
The Lords of Lords.
The Lord of Lords.
Wonderful.
Wonderful.
Counselor.
Mighty God,
mighty God,
everlasting Father,
everlasting Father,
I worship you,
I worship you,
I adore you,
I adore you.
Say, wonderful Holy Ghost,
wonderful Holy Ghost,
I surrender to you,
I surrender to you,
I open my heart,
I open my heart,
I open my spirit,
I open my spirit.
Teach me your word.
Teach me your word.
Reveal to me.
Reveal to me.
Your divine revelations.
Your divine revelations.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
The Bible says that where two or three comes together in my name, Jesus said that there I am in their midst, and also tonight Jesus Christ is here, the Holy Ghost is here, God Almighty is here, angels are here. We are in the presence of God and we'll have a privilege to sing unto God tonight. Let us get ready to sing unto God tonight.
And Omega.
Doctor. Also tonight we will have the privilege to go through the word of God together and the word of testimony tonight.
Amen.
Amen.
Our testimony reads as follows. Healed from severe period pains. There is a lady who saw one of the posts on Facebook about the testimonies of what God is doing in people's lives. She has been suffering from severe period pains for more than 10 years. These period pains affected her whole body. Whenever her menstrual cycle began in such a way, she couldn't even walk. She resorted to using pills to ease the pain in order for her to attend classes. Pastor Robert prayed for her and she felt her head spinning. Then suddenly got dizzy. When she checked her tummy, she could not feel any pain anymore. She is healed. Glory to God in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Our announcements are as follows. Every morning at 6 a.m. from Monday to Friday, we have our morning prayer, which is at 7 a.m. on Saturdays and Sundays. Our midday service starts at 5 to 12. And then we have our evening service, which starts at 6 p.m. every night. Our midnight prayer starts at 5 to 12 every night. And we also have our weekly prayer and fasting, which is on Wednesdays, Thursdays, and Fridays. The details of the fasting are shared on our different WhatsApp groups. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight, we'll get the word of God from the book of Luke chapter 4 from verse 29, NIV. It reads as follows. They got up, drove him out of the town, and took him to the brow of the hill on which the town was built, in order to throw him off the cliff. But he walked right through the crowd and went on his way. Then he went down to Capernaum, a town in Galilee, and on the Sabbath he taught the people. They were amazed at his teaching, because his words had authority. In the synagogue, there was a man possessed by a demon, an impure spirit. He cried out at the top of his voice, "Go away, what do you want with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." "Be quiet," Jesus said sternly. "Come out of him." Then the demon threw the man down before them all and came out without injuring him. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Also tonight, family, we will have a privilege to go through the word of God together. and the word, believing the word of God to be taught with power, the power of the Holy Spirit, power to heal, power to bless, power to protect, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Then tonight, let us go to the book of Luke chapter 4. Let us read from verse number 17, going downwards, before we go to verse number 29. The Bible says that, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him. Unrolling it, he found the place where it is written, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to proclaim good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of the sight of the blind, and to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor." Then the Bible is talking about Jesus Christ in the synagogue. In the synagogue, this was after the time that he had been praying and fasting. And the Bible says that when Jesus Christ was in the synagogue, he opened the scroll in the book of prophet Isaiah. When he opened the scroll, the Bible said that he opened the place where it was written, "The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he have anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor, and to send, he have sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and the recovery of the sight of the blind, and to set the oppressed free." The Bible says that he said that. And the Bible says that in verse number 21, he began by saying to them, "This scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." I want to tell you this. It was not as if it was the first time at the synagogue. I'm talking about those who were there. They've been there in the synagogue for years. Maybe every Sabbath, they go to the synagogue to listen to the reading of the scrolls, the reading of the scriptures, different, having a different interpreters of the word of God. But there was no day, there was no time anybody have given the word of God as Jesus Christ had on this particular day. And the Bible said that, you know, Jesus said that to them. You know, the Bible said that the Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he have anointed me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He have anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor. They know that verse. It was not the first time when they are hearing the verse. They know the verse. Many people have read it. They've heard different interpretation. But there was never anyone who has ever said, "Hey, today this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing." Then it was the first time. To them, they thought, "Oh, this is blasphemy. How can anybody ever say something like this?" You know, and Jesus Christ have said something, and he said that, you know, "You err because you do not know the scriptures." They err because they don't understand the scriptures. They don't know that the word of God is talking about one person who's Jesus Christ. They don't know that, you know, the Torah, the Old Testament, the prophets talks about Jesus. The prophet Isaiah is talking about Jesus. Even though the prophet Isaiah is talking about Jesus, they don't know it. Actually, they are offended of it. Whereas, if they had a revelation and an understanding of the scriptures, they were supposed to celebrate. that, oh, the Lord have come, the Messiah have come, the Savior have come, that we may be free. Because Moses talked about the coming of Jesus. Not only Moses. Isaiah talked about the coming of Jesus. Yet they read these verses. They read these scriptures and never understood what the prophet was talking about. And you know, it is not only this. The Bible talks about there was a man, Ethiopian eunuch. The Bible said that he will usually go to the temple at Jerusalem. Then he will go to worship most of the time. And the Bible said that he did this by going to the temple in Jerusalem. And he was on his chariot on his way back to Ethiopia. And the Bible says that this was the time that Jesus Christ had died, resurrected, and went back to heaven. But the Bible said that God talked and took Philip, one who was the disciple of Jesus, and said that, go and meet this man, and took him supernaturally. When he arrived, he find Philip. He find this Ethiopian eunuch reading the word of God. He's reading in the book of Isaiah. As when he's reading in the book of Isaiah, he's reading, continuing to read, but does not understand what the word of God talks about. But he's trying to read. In the similar act, he wants to pray. He wants to have a fellowship with God. He took his time and he also went to Jerusalem, thinking that God is still in the temple in Jerusalem. And the Bible says that when Philip found him, Philip said that, what are you reading about? He said, I'm reading what the prophet have written. He said, do you understand what you're reading about? He said, no, I don't understand. That's when Philip said, no, let me tell you. And he tell him all about Jesus. So actually the prophet is talking about Jesus. Jesus Christ have come. Jesus Christ have died. Jesus Christ has resurrected. And the Bible say that when you have heard so, he said, what shall I do? Because I've heard about the gospel of Jesus. The Bible say that as he was on that chariot together, there was a stream of water. He said, what can stop me now from being baptized? And the Bible said nothing can stop you from being baptized. And he was baptized in water. And after that, the Holy Ghost took Philip back to where he was. He disappeared. Then I want to tell you this. In a similar manner, Jesus, these teachers of the law and these people who were in this synagogue, it is not as if they were not studying this word of God. They were meditating in the Old Testament way without the Holy Spirit. Without being born again, without being filled of the Holy Ghost. And as they were reading that word, they could not understand. They are reading, they are studying, they can't understand. That's why even when the Lord appears, instead of saying, oh, everybody to stand up and celebrate, and celebrate and begin to worship God. Oh, the Lord have come. The Messiah have come. It's the time of our salvation. They don't do so. Instead, they get offended. They get offended and say that, why does he say such kind of a thing? Why does he say such kind of a thing? That today this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing. You know, that's the problem of not being spiritual. You know, there are people who are not spiritual. Then they cannot discern and apprehend the spiritual things. Even when God is moving and God is doing something, they cannot capture what God is doing. These are the people who are not like Anna. These are the people who are not like Simeon. The Bible said that Anna was a woman of God, was a prophet of God. And the Bible said that Anna is a prophet of God. He was only married for 7 years. And her husband died. After when her husband died, the Bible said that she stayed in the temple. As she stood in the temple, the Bible says that she dedicated their life to worship God for the rest of her life. In prayer and in fasting. In such a way that the day that the baby Jesus Christ was born was brought into the temple for circumcision. As per the Jewish custom. And the Bible says that Anna could discern that this is the Lord. This baby is not an ordinary baby. This baby is the Lord. Same thing happened to Simeon. When the Bible said that this man of God, who was staying in the house of God, who have made a vow with God, and said that even though I'm very old, I'm not going to die until I see the Lord.
Amen.
And the Bible said that the way that he was so old, he was beginning to be blind. But the Bible said that when the baby was brought into the temple, he carried the baby and worshipped God. And said that God, now he can go. Because he has seen the salvation of Israel. I'm talking about these people are way spiritual, and that's why they could discern the spiritual things. The problem now, Jesus is not even a baby. Jesus is not even a baby. It is his time. Every child is coming from 40 days and 40 nights. Coming full of the power of the Holy Ghost. Standing before them. Instead of saying, we want to benefit from what the Lord. And celebrate the coming of the Lord. They get offended. You know, sometimes they might have looked at how he looked. And for sure, coming from 40 days and 40 nights, this day maybe he's even skinnier. And they say that, what is this one trying to do? But it was not just the men of God who was in their midst. It was not just the man of God who was in their midst. It was the Lord himself.
Amen.
How can somebody be so blind and be carnal and miss the Lord himself? If you can meet the man of God, okay, we'll understand. But these people were not in spirit. They were not channeled to accept the Lord. They were not channeled to identify the Lord. Child of God, you need to position yourself.
Amen.
Position yourself where, you know, you must end up being like an Abraham. Who God says that you are the friend, you are his, or you are his friend.
Amen.
And his friend, God said that I don't want to do anything without revealing it to you. In such a way that God will reveal to you that tomorrow. It's not an ordinary man who's coming there. This is the Lord. Be ready.
Amen.
And you will be celebrating the Lord that day. Imagine, and this is not happening in the marketplace. This is not happening in the marketplace, but this is happening. This is happening in the house of God.
Amen.
People can go to church and still be so carnal.
Amen.
You know, these are the kind of the people who doesn't maintain the relationship with God, and it becomes just a religion. It just becomes an act, an empty act. No, we need to be spiritual and be in spirit in such a way that you will be able to discern when the Lord is visiting.
Amen.
May the Holy Ghost help us in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says that after that, let us read from verse number 29 of Luke chapter 4. They got up to drove him out of the town and took him to the brow of the hill, which the town is built, in order to throw him off the cliff. The Bible, these people were so angry. You know, in Israel, they are so religious. They are so religious. In such a way that if anybody could say that there is a Messiah, they will not just listen to it. They will want to kill that person. Also that day, they wanted to kill Jesus. This was not an act that they were just holding him and pushing him out of the temple. No. This was the act which they are trying to take him out of town and throw him off the cliff, thinking that he will not survive this. To them, they are thinking, he will not survive this. It is over with his life. Not knowing that it is not his time. And Jesus Christ is powerful. Nobody was going to kill him if it was not his time, if he did not want to die. Don't think that crucifixion was an accident. Crucifixion was not an accident. It was him wanted to be crucified, surrendering to be crucified. The Lord, the way he's so powerful, if he did not want to be crucified, nobody could.
Amen.
Then crucifixion, it was not, hey, them overpowering Jesus, arresting Jesus, crucifying him on the cross. No, it was not.
Amen.
Crucifixion was the Lord laying down his life, surrendering his life for our sake.
Amen.
So that whoever believes upon him shall be saved and have everlasting life.
Amen.
Then they did not know. They think Jesus Christ is an ordinary man. And the Bible says that they hold him. And they drove him out of town. And the Bible says they wanted to kill him. They wanted to throw him on the cliff. Oh, read verse number 30. The Bible says that then, but he walked right through the crowd and went on his way. Hey, the whole crowd. I'm telling you, this is the similar thing when you're talking about mob justice. It was mob justice of their day.
Amen.
Everybody is saying that he's the one. What have you done? He claimed he's the Messiah. Then everybody was angry. They wanted to kill him. But the Bible said that he walked through them. Ha 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 ha. I'm talking to somebody tonight. I don't know what kind of the group of the people who are planning what, who have orchestrated what. They don't know that you are the child of God. Jesus Christ is in you.
Amen.
Jesus Christ is in us.
Amen.
The Lion of the tribe of Judah is in us.
Amen.
Alpha and Omega is in us.
Amen.
You will walk through them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We will walk through them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know what kind of trouble you are in.
Amen.
What kind of a challenge you are in. I don't know what the devil has planned. I don't know what the witches have planned. But I'm talking to somebody, as Jesus Christ is in you. Jesus Christ is in us. When the Bible says that Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Amen.
You're going to walk out of that problem in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We are walking out of it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That day, everyone in the crowd were wondering, how did he pass? Where is he? How did he come out? I see whatever and whoever who were orchestrating whatever anything against us, they will wonder, how did you come out of it?
Amen.
Because you are the child of the mighty God.
Amen.
And greater is he that's within us than he that is in the world.
Amen.
And you are more than the conqueror. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm talking to somebody, child of God, I say, fear nothing.
Amen.
Greater than the greatest is by our side.
Amen.
Mightier than the mightiest is by our side.
Amen.
The Bible says that in the book of 1 John chapter 4, verse number 4. The Bible says that, you dear children are from God. And the Bible says that, and have overcome them. Because the one who is in you is greater than the one that is in the world.
Amen.
You, dear children, hey, you are not ordinary.
Amen.
You are from God.
Amen.
You are born after the second Adam.
Amen.
You are not born after the first Adam.
Amen.
But you are born after the second Adam. And the Bible says that when they were now trying to throw Jesus onto the cliff, hey, he walked through them.
Amen.
Oh, Prada Shantali Bradoso Frayandalabaha.
Amen.
The Bible says that one day, it was the time that Apostle Peter was in prison. And the Bible says that by this time, they've killed one of the sons of Zebedee. And the Bible says that now Herod, because you realize that what you have done, it pleased the Jews. The Bible says that he was planning to kill also Peter. And the Bible says that as he was planning to kill Peter, the Bible says that the church was praying. The church was praying. And the Bible said that as the church was praying, the Bible said that it was during the night. The Bible said Peter was not even praying. But the angel entered prison and hit Peter when he was, let's say, wake up. When he woke up, the Bible said that, hey, but that time all the guards, the angel have made them to sleep. I'm talking to somebody. I don't know who are the guards.
Amen.
Of your situation, but I command them to sleep.
Amen.
I command them to slumber.
Amen.
They won't see you coming out.
Amen.
They will wonder, how did you come out?
Amen.
How did you come out of that problem?
Amen.
How did you come out of that situation?
Amen.
We are the children of the mighty God.
Amen.
The lion of the tribe of Judah is in us.
Amen.
Alpha and Omega is in us.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
I see each and every one of us coming out of every problem miraculously.
Amen.
The Bible says that. The Bible says that Peter woke up, and the angel, as they were walking out, the door, prison door was just opening. All the guards were asleep. All the process, all the procedures are sleeping for you in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I'm saying that we are coming out by fire, by force in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
There will be a supernatural breakthrough by fire, by force in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know what kind of a miracle are you looking for.
Amen.
Maybe the kind of the miracle that you are looking for, you is a job. Don't worry. Those HR people will sleep.
Amen.
They will not follow procedure this time for your sake.
Amen.
Oh, everything, it will turn around for you, our good.
Amen.
It will turn around for your good.
Amen.
If they think that you are ordinary, they are about to see that you are the child of the Almighty God.
Amen.
We serve a mighty God.
Amen.
We serve a great God.
Amen.
I'm trying to tell child of God, fear nothing.
Amen.
Greater is he that's within us than he that is in the world.
Amen.
That's what the Bible said, that child of God, children of God, you have overcome them.
Amen.
Hey, you have overcome them.
Amen.
Can you say, I have overcome them?
I have overcome them.
I have overcome them.
I have overcome
them. I have overcome them.
I have overcome them.
I am coming out.
I am coming out.
Miraculously.
Miraculously.
I'm saying, child of God, you are not going to go through with what the world of God is going through.
Amen.
If we serve the living God, if I serve the living God, I said to you, don't worry how the economy is going.
Amen.
Don't worry who says what.
Amen.
We serve a mighty God.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Something is happening wherever you need a miracle in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Something is happening. The power of God is talking for us.
Amen.
The anointing is talking for us.
Amen.
Those who are against us, I put them into confusion in the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Power which is more powerful than the power of witchcraft.
Amen.
Power which is more powerful than the power of sangoma.
Amen.
Than the power of any witch.
Amen.
It is at work in our life.
Amen.
And it is work is changing things for our good.
Amen.
I don't know whether I'm talking to somebody. If we serve a living God, because we serve a living God, you will come back with a testimony.
Amen.
You will come back with a proof.
Amen.
That we serve God of signs and wonders.
Amen.
The one who can appear with a miracle and a solution and who can do what no man can ever do.
Amen.
The Bible said that Jesus Christ, hey, he walked right through the crowd.
Amen.
Can you imagine those who were, hey, heading this thing? They were asking themselves, where is he? Amen. How did he come? They said, there he is. Amen. How did it happen? I don't know. They were like, that is power.
Amen.
I'm saying to you, at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what you're going through. I'm saying to you, they will see the power of God in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And say that you serve a living God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The bigger the problem, the bigger the testimony.
Amen.
Then when you see the problem, you must say that it is time to see God's power.
Amen.
It is time to see God's grace.
Amen.
I don't know whether you are hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Power of God is made manifest in challenges.
Amen.
Wherever you have seen a miracle, there was a problem that the power was solving.
Amen.
And the power of God is solving the problem that we are in, and you are in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Akaravase kerere shekereba son toloboha. Hey, as the power is at work tonight, setting you free, making a way where there seems to be no way. Begin to pray, begin to pray. Akaraba yekebebe, shandala kaika tokorokoshe, rakinege, paria, lurobo siandarabe, udororyanaraba yenderyanduru, yekebeba sotorebeki, udoryandorobo, Mandere Rekeba. Parabayeketeleba. Yandalaba sandolobo. Barikado sakita kaika torobo. Yandarabayeteria. Paikato, paikato. Jekitaraba sheketereba. Mandorobos yandarabayuna. Penderian Dorobos Yandarabaika Rebe Shekerebe Araka Shekeria Kariabaye Toriabaye. The one who appeared by Miracle Apia. The one who appeared by Santel Wanda Apia. Show that you are the Alpha and Omega. And apart to but there is no other. Roko shekeri kato roko shikada. Yendele ba sekete ba. Roko rebe shekerebe teriyabaye. Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost, Holy Ghost. Them to the abyss.
I command them to the abyss.
Anything which is not of God,
anything which is not of God,
in my life,
in my body,
in my career,
in our country,
in every sector of my life,
in every sector of my life,
catch fire now.
Catch fire now.
I command them.
I command them.
Come out.
Come out.
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 Say, I command.
I command.
Everything to turn around for my good.
Everything to turn around for my good.
Everything.
Everything.
Turn around.
Turn around.
For my good.
For my good.
So let there be progress.
Let there be progress.
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 In the name of Jesus Christ.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Say, Lord Jesus Christ.
Lord Jesus Christ.
You are my Lord.
You are my Lord.
You are my Savior.
You are my Savior.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Forgive me my sins. Bless me today.
Bless me today.
Protect me from today.
Protect me from today.
With your power.
With your power.
Of the Holy Spirit.
Of the Holy Spirit.
From today.
Today.
I am born again.
I am born again.
I am saved.
I am saved.
Say, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ.
The love of God.
The love of God.
The fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
The fellowship of the Holy Spirit.
Be with us all.
Be with us all.
Surely goodness and love.
Surely goodness and love.
Shall follow me.
Shall follow me.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
And I dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Tonight, if you have got a torch wherever you are, some of your hands are shining right now. Some of your hands are shining right now. If you have got a pain in your body, that pain is gone. If you are sick in your body, that sickness is gone. If you have got a problem in your life, that problem is gone. Mandaraba shekerebeketeriaba. Check yourself. If you have got a torch in wherever you are, I don't know, there's somebody's hands that are shining as I speak, and they are increasing as I speak right now. Look at that. I see this young man's hands here. Joshua's hands are shining like diamonds. Come and have a look. Rakate paria kataraba kataria bakateria. You are God who answers by miracles, signs, and wonders. Let there be wonders all over right now. wonders that favors us right now. If you are sick, check that pain right now. Check that pain right now. Check that pain right now. Check your life right now. Check your life right now. Something is happening. Something is happening. Every sickness disappear.
Amen.
Every problem disappear.
Amen.
Let there be miracle jobs.
Amen.
Let somebody get the miracle promotion in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The miracle that you have been looking for, I give you 7 days in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Something is happening. Something is happening. Something is happening. I say, if you have got a torch right now, the first sign and the wonder now, somebody's hands are shining.
Amen.
Yeah, this one, it was as if there is a diamond. I see Makura Tendo's hands. They are shining there wherever she is. I see something is happening. Something is changing. Something is changing. Something is changing. Likranto prahakida zavradiyase. Lakianto prahakidas, afrahakidas, sofrahakidas. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Congratulations.
Amen.
If you don't, if you have got enough miracle and your bank of miracle is enough, just say back to the sender, I need this miracle. Just say back to the sender. But I know, this kind of word does not fall down.
Amen.
No, I was praying for this other lady. Mama Elizabeth's hands are also shining in Kempton Park. They are shining as we speak. That's what she wrote. You know, as I was praying for this lady, I was at the plant. The same thing that used to happen when, you know, like at the plant, there's a place where the water is dripping. I could see the oil separate. The same thing that I used to see when we were walking with Paul Lazarus when it's raining. And you can see the water separating. I was seeing it this morning. Yes, something is happening where you need a miracle right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Just receive that miracle. Just receive that miracle. Just receive that breakthrough. This word is not going to fall down. It's not going to fall down. There are angels that are sent, which are busy. Right now, they are busy. They are making things happen for our good. Eka, eka. La karabasheke terebakadia. Africanto prahakidas, oprahakidas, efrahakidas, oprahakides. Lente keriabaha. I want to say to you tonight, may God bless you. Have a blessed and a wonderful night in Jesus' name.
Bye-bye, everybody. Have a blessed morning, day and afternoon and night.
Amen. Bye-bye.